Alright. Welcome back. Are you ready for some more Mega Man action? Oh, I am. Let's get started. This is the opening. The city is full of explosions. We're gonna need your help once again, Mega Man. Better get equipped with something new. Something very powerful. This time equipped with a new powerful Mega Buster. And then Mega Man 4 starts. Press start. And 8 new Robot Masters await you. As well as our Dr. Cossack in the middle. Let's go with Toadman. He is, in my opinion, the easiest boss in the whole series, if you know what you're doing. I'll show you when we get to his room. Sound balance between me talking and the game itself should be better as well. Instead of the previous Mega Man theme. So this is a rainy stage at first. The rain will push Mega Man a little bit backwards. But soon enough you will enter the sewers. As Toadman likes to hide downwards down in here. The water falling down here will also push you a little bit. So be mindful of your jumps. So Mega Man 4's only new introduction, major new introduction, is the Mega Buster. Instead of just shooting with 3 normal bullets, you can also charge up your action button. And then it will unleash a more powerful shot. Which will be useful in general. Here we've got a mini boss. Uh, And other than being able to summon Rush in this game, like the previous one, you will also be able to summon Eddie soon enough. And Eddie is another supportive ally who will drop random items at you. It's like playing the lottery. Either you get, sometimes you get used for items, or sometimes you get nothing at all. I might not even die if I know what I'm doing. Let's see. No. I will show you how Toadman behaves now. Just keep hitting him like that from a close point. He'll just keep jumping back and forth. He will not be able to do anything at all. Hence making him the easiest boss in the whole series. So Toadman is a joke to me. You got Rain Flush, and also you got Rush Marine Adapter. The White Man is up next. Rain Flush won't have many uses. Except for this Robomaster coming up. And I don't know when Rush Marine will be useful. We'll see when that will be needed. So White Man is another stage like Shadow Man that plays with darkness. The red ones will, if you destroy them, you will produce darkness. And if you destroy the green ones, they will emit lightness or light. If you jump on these, what are those, grasshoppers? They'll just jump around. Here you need to jump before you fall to your doom. You've got two options. You can either go downstairs using this ladder or go the other way. Oh no, here was here are just only two useful items at the end. So you need to backtrack a little bit. I'm using Wash Girl just to make sure. Why is it not dropping? Oh. That didn't make any sense. Brightman stage is pretty unusual in so far as enemy design goes. He is electrical and light based, but his enemies are all over the place. Got a full life meter. Let's use Rain Flush right away. Let's see how Brightman likes it. Oh yeah, he can also stop time temporarily. He still killed me though. Let's deplete this weapon and then switch over to regular Buster. He isn't that aggressive, just jumping around, shooting a little bit, and sometimes using his Brightstopper or something. Let's see what the official name is. Flashstopper. And from Brightman, we go to... I think it was Pharaoh, man. So this is a desert-based stage. Somehow set in outer space, or it might just be quite dark outside. I think there's more if I make that jump. Oh, I didn't make it. Oh well. A lot of mummies will now appear, throwing their heads at you, of all things. I should get that E-tank. Uh, Was just acting in strange ways. It's as if the physics of the game don't apply always with him. Here you've got the bats returning from the second game. Ah. These eight Robot Masters, they were the first eight bosses that were created by fans, Mega Man fans from Japan, from what I understand. They were able to send in their designs towards Capcom, and over 10,000 or maybe more were sent in, and they had to narrow it down to eight winning bosses, and then these eight came out of top of all of them. So that was a pretty nifty idea and kind of fan service back in those days. And they would continue to do that for the next for Mega Man 5 and 6 as well. Let's make this jump now. Let's see what is up here. Maybe there's a special item waiting for me. I can vaguely remember... Oh, there was an extra life. Remember a special item in this game as well. This is the B item. What is that again? Balloon. So that is similar to special item 1 from Mega Man 2. There might be several other special items here as well. I'm not sure where the others are from the top of my head. Just keep my eyes out. Pharaoh Man might be the hardest of this game. He's able to charge up his Pharaoh shot. If that hits you, it will hurt plenty. Now let's try using Flash Stopper. Let's see how much that will hurt for him. Oh, I'll have to use it several times. Oh. nice use of Out of Fire. It feels kind of cheap. Still fun to use though. You got fellow shots. I assume you can also charge up this shot. And now it's time for my favorite Bubble Master in the whole series, the Ringman. Just listen to this tune. It's another vertical stage. It has space elements. Here you've got a weird mini boss coming up. You need to bring the hippo down in order to hit it. But the platform will keep regenerating itself, so just keep firing at it. Ah, stupid me. Zero lives. I'm gonna kill myself and start over so that my lives will be restocked again. Good old password system. I used to write down those passwords alongside with my brother back in the early 90s. And nowadays any game, modern game, pretty much has an autosave feature. How spoiled we have become. Using the other fire is a little bit cheap. I won't use it again. Now let's get further. Here's another mini boss for you. He's only vulnerable when he throws his wings out and his eyes open. And another mini boss. This stage has many mini bosses. So I think there's another special item above there. Let's check it out. Here's Eddie. Oh, it's just an Eddie area. Eddie, you can find, you cannot summon him, but you can find him in certain areas of this game. So these platforms act a little bit different. They will drop down faster than the other rainbow ones. I guess these are more ring based. Fourth mini boss. Okay, made it. Rayman only has one move with his rain boomerangs, but it's a fast move. He throws it twice and then runs towards you. Let's use his weakness. So I'm charging up the Pharaoh shot. Yeah. So that's four Robo Masters down. You got Ring Boomerang. Can this one throw also be thrown in eight directions? I think Skullman is up next. Skullman is the general favorite boss of this game. Also a pretty good design in general. His music, his stage, his the way he looks. So that's a skeleton Joe you just saw. Joe likes to return in several forms in each game. Thank you, Eddie. So now I just won the lottery. Oh, let's get that heat tank. Thank you. can only hit them from the front, not from behind. Those Spinkus enemies. Another E-Tank. As you may have noticed, some items will also emit or charge up if you are charging up your Mega Buster. A nice touch. Okay, I made it. There's a Skullman. And like Woodman, he also has a shield. The Skull Shield. Let's try Ring Boomerang, and I can only shoot it forward, unfortunately, not upwards, or diagonally, or downwards. It's not his weakness, I got it wrong. Let's defeat him in a normal way then. Oh, hey, Mega Man. I didn't see you checking out my stream. Nice to see you. You got Skull Barrier. Not Skull Shield, but Barrier. Diver Man. A water-based... Bubble Master. The invisibility frame saved me there. As far as I know, you cannot defeat these enemies. Just avoid them. Here are the Metars swimming on the water. And here's a whale mini boss for you. This game introduces a lot of mini. No, it doesn't introduce mini bosses, but throws plenty of them at you. That's very generous of you, Eddie. Thank you. And the enemies will respawn here as well if you just walk away. Oh, let's get hit on purpose. Ah. I thought I could escape that. But I got an extra life. So it's all good, man. Hey, you better watch out not to jump too early. You need to have the water rising up as high as possible so that you can jump higher. Time for dive, man. Not too hard. By skull barrier. It is his weakness. You still gotta watch out for body damage from the bosses. Those were hit the most. You got dive missile. Let's go with Wilman. I remember Dustman having the hardest stage because he has rising platforms that will instantly kill you if you don't watch out. I'll show you soon enough, but first Drillman is up. It's a mining area. A lot of drilling gets done here. Hit them too early, otherwise they won't waste their shields. But don't be too late as well. Another E-tank. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, they will drop some kind of garbage at you. Those parts. If you flip those switches, platforms will appear. So always go for the switches. They hit pretty hard, those falling builders. Let's just use an energy tank, I've got 4 more left anyway. Maybe dive man? Or dive missile? Let's see. That seems to work. But the drillman likes to hide around a lot. Really? There's one more life bar left. Now I'll get it. And this is my final life, so better finish it. You got little bomb, and you also got rush jet adapter. Always helpful. So one more stage, but I wonder if there is a special item I'm missing. I simply don't remember. But maybe it's not needed for the final stages coming after this. This looks like some kind of recycle factory. Oh, I've got one more life. I'm gonna kill myself. Because this is a hard stage. You'll see soon enough. These blocks, they won't disappear, so they are more friendly than the ones we saw in the previous games, and they're also larger, definitely more friendly. So this part will be difficult. At one point in this, somewhere in this area, you will have to slide just at the right time, otherwise you'll be crushed to your death from above. And you also need to destroy these blocks before you attempt to do it. Might as well use all the fire for this occasion. Just destroy all these blocks. Got it one again. I thought there was another section with those falling platforms. Maybe I overestimated it. So this is Dustman. He likes to suck you towards him and throw junk at you. If he's not gonna jump, then he's also pretty easy to defeat. Just jump upwards when he throws it at you. They'll never hit you. Also very easy. You got Dust Crusher. Now Dr. Cossack has appeared, a former partner, colleague, and friend of Dr. Light and Dr. Wily. Well, let's just get on with this. If I need another special item, I'll have to think really hard where to obtain it. Otherwise, let's just get this done. This is Cossacks Fortress. He is a Russian scientist. As you might have guessed from his name. Better watch out, eh? It's a little bit slippery here as well on those platforms. Slide down there, you'll just fall to your death. Thank you, Skull Joe. So here you can use Rush Coil, Rush Jet, and this balloon. But look, as you can see, I'm still missing one bar, so there's one more special item somewhere. I just don't remember where it is. Oh well, we'll see how far I get. Maybe Russ will be enough to let me beat this guy. And this balloon as well. Almost there. Let's see what's up next. I saw it coming, but still I wasn't able to jump away. It's not a difficult fortress boss, it's doable. Did you see that? He just disappeared the moment he hit me, and I knocked back a little bit. Oh, I slipped there. Thank you. It's a little shortcut if I use the balloons there. As long as I don't get hit. Oh, come on. The enemies are in the way. About its weakness. I felt content with the Mega Buster already. Maybe use an E-Tank or not, we'll see. Yeah, I'll use one. This fortress boss, it can destroy the floor you're standing on, if you allow it. But it will be dead usually, before it gets a chance. Jet here. Still not sure when to use Rush Marine in this game. Well, they changed Rush Jet a little bit in this game. You're no longer able to move in all directions. You'll just keep moving forwards automatically. Oh, that's nice. But it's too risky to get it. Those spikes, they won't instantly kill you, but they will damage you. You gotta time it just right. And then you can jump over them. Get those items. but I need to be mindful of that enemy. Oh, dwell bomb, we'll do that 2 times. West coil will get me there. An extra life. Let's try to get it. Nice. So 3 lives, 4 energy tanks. I have no clue what is up, what is coming up next. Let's try Wind Boomerang first. Oh yeah, this loss. No, immune. You can only hit it when that red orb is attacking. It doesn't respawn me at the boss doors, which is disappointing. Always slide under it whenever it's moving very fast. One more hit. Boom. Well done. And now it's time for Kozak Stage 3 with a new tune. This is an out of scrolling stage, meaning the stage will move on its own. Mm-hmm. now the stage changes more in a vertical one. Yeah, those saw blades are just annoying. Here's some more auto scrolling. Now just drop down, otherwise you won't make it. And if you are fast enough, I think the ring boomerang can catch it. No, it can't. How do I get that one? How the hell? Huh. I've got no idea, to be honest. I'm curious though. Or maybe for another time. So what is this? Well, not much to say about this Fortress boss. They're pretty doable so far. So this is the final Cossack stage. It's time to get him and approach him. So now I can go two ways. Let's go this way. It seems more interesting. Maybe there's some goodies waiting for me. Alright. Thank you. Ah, it's time for a confrontation with the doctor. And there he is. The final boss. Wow, is that it? He didn't even hit me. I'm gonna break you, Mega Man. So plot twist, Dr. Wily is behind the evil schemes yet again. And there are his eyebrows again. So these are the two final stages coming up. Oh yeah, I think this is the special Madara stage. Only Madaras will attack you in all kinds of forms. Some of them like to perform a little dance. This might be tricky. Back. Oh, what is back? Okay, now I need to memorize where they appear. Thank you, Metor. So generous of you. You're making this all very easy for me. So now the first Wily Fortress boss is upon me. So I've got 7 energy tanks. That's quite overpowering. So it's a large Metor you'll have to fight. It's intimidating, but also cute in a kind of way. Thank you. It's another easy boss. Not sure what its weakness is, but I won't need it. Yeah, Mega Man 4 has one of my favorite Mega Man soundtracks. From the classic series. Lots of spikes here. Let's try the balloon. Higher above. Slide jet from here. This is a little bit safer. Hey Eddie. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Just another. Oh, that was nasty. Just another energy tank for me. It's a completely pointless spot there in the lower left corner. I try to jump upwards there, but I can also slide to the left. Something tells me I need to use Trail Bomb here. But that's not it. Yeah, Ring Boomerang is working. Also pretty easy. In some ways it might even be easier than Mega Man 2. I've got so many energy tanks, I just don't know what to do with them. Other than drink lots of them. I And now I even get more lives and energy tanks. Now the Wily teleportation pod system starts again. It's time for round 2 of all the Robot Masters. Well, Toadman, you know what to do by now. But in case you're wondering what his true weakness is, Veil Bomb. And now he won't even jump away. He attempts to use his rainbow dance, but I'm too fast to let him do that. Skull or barrier? He got me. Oh, he got me again. Now let's use the Mega Buster. Alright, I'll use an energy tank. And as for Skull Man, maybe dust? Yes. Rain Flush. But still, he's able to keep attacking. Yeah, his body hits more than his normal attack. I got frozen there. I just thought for a moment I would be frozen indefinitely. Dive missile. three more. Maybe Ring Boomerang? Yes. Why do I get hit? Oh, that was pretty bad. Pharaoh shots. I believe Pharaoh shot is also the weakness of the Wily capsule or the final boss this game. We'll see soon enough. Flash or white man. Poor Pharaoh, man. Imagine being tortured like that. Sounds like hell to me. So, this is the first Wily face. I've got three more lives. Let's stick with the Mega Buster. Just keep below his shots, they won't hit you or that. And use slide if needed. And as for this part, okay, it looks like I need to hit the upper part now. Maybe dive? No, it won't reach. How or what can reach him? Nothing seems to hit. What do I do? Maybe if I jump up there with Rush Coil or use the balloon, I'll still be able to hit him. It does, but it deals little damage. I wonder what its weakness is here. Oh. Need to be careful. It sucks, you cannot seem to hit him if you jump at your highest, normally. Maybe if I charge my Buster, I can hit him, fortunately. I have to jump at my very highest and then hit him. Okay, that makes things easier. I will use an energy tank if needed. While he escapes. So this is the 12th final stage. Almost there. I got zero lives. I'm gonna kill myself right away. Just let these guys kill me. This is it. Final boss. So he only appears very briefly. How do I hit him? Maybe Pharaoh shot. If I can hit him. Okay, I got him. But he needs to be close. Alright. One more hit. Boom! How clever of you. Wow, it's a skull cloud. And now the credits roll. Mega Man seems to have lowered his helmet in order to catch the breeze on this moving train. I don't think back in those days anyone would have thought that they would ever create a Mega Man 4, 5 and 6 on the NES. It's kind of nice to have 6 titles. Here are some more credits. And the designers. Or the fans who made them. Presented by Capcom. Just Capcom. No more Capcom USA. And I think that's it. That's the end. The very end of Mega Man 4. Another entertaining entry and sequel to revisit. So thanks again for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one.